exactly where I was when I first saw you, the way I see you now through these eyes, waiting to retry those pristine days I recall so fondly. So few are the trials when a life isn't lonely, and now if only I'd never felt it. Suspicion, no hesitation, believing through the eyes of sure adoration. Tremors, mind at its weakest, one way of shaking off the thoughts that it sleeps with.
Wake up, people. Fish Center time.
The world of Christmas.
708-794-6386. So you're out to lunch, huh, Max? Is that your deal? You're out to lunch.
No, I was late.
What does that mean, out to lunch?
He's checked out.
I wasn't checked out. I was
busy. Moved on. He wants to do Tender Touches and Blood Feast. We get it.
I was drawing. Wow. I had to draw
this care anymore.
Paper crane with all these dimensional shapes around it, and I was having so much fun making Dave's face out of lines that I just got lost.
Just go do it. We don't want to stop you.
No, yeah. I can do this too. That's the great thing, is I'm really talented.
I had a terrible lunch today.
What'd you have?
A burrito that I shouldn't have ordered.
From where?
I don't want to shit talk. No, I don't want to shit talk restaurants that are just trying.
Not if it was
new restaurants that are trying stuff.
Does it have teeth in it?
No, but it had like, I think I had chicken bones.
Oh,
put some chicken
bones.
On purpose.
So it's a place you hadn't been to before.
No, I've been there.
Give us a clue.
Rhymes with Billy's.
That is kind of a
Silly's Funny Burritos.
A discount chain.
Yeah.
No, it's not. It's the best chain in Atlanta.
Hell no.
Hell no.
What's the best chain in Atlanta?
I strongly disagree.
Probably McDonald's.
No, for burritos, Bar Burritos is the only place to go.
Is that a
but
chain?
But that's coming from a guy who hates Mexican food.
Well, that's fair. But burritos are Tex-Mex, technically.
Oh.
All right.
Bar Burritos.
I go now to La Hacienda, and I get their chorizo queso dip. But now I do shock jock humor on the air.
This burrito had queso poured all over it, and then fajita peppers and onions that weren't cooked.
A world of Christmas.
And chicken bone.
Right
I bet there wasn't chicken
Center
bone.
Is Max's nest show. What does that mean?
What does that mean? I don't know what these phrases mean.
That's because you're not a millennial, dude.
All these troubled teens in the chat making things up and doing memes. Catch me outside.
How about that? I get it now.
Fish Center is my rah-rah shish goomba.
You're just making that up.
No, rah-rah shish goomba. Don't people say that?
You're making that up. It's
what
not what
they
that?
Say. Rah-rah shish goomba.
Don't give up on it, Dave.
You're thinking
I think
of...
it's shish goomba, not shish goomba.
Shish goomba.
I don't know.
Sounds like a Greek
shish
dish.
Shish goomba.
Shish goomba.
I've been saying my catchphrase wrong my whole life.
Fish Center is a show. Fish Corp. Have we been enjoying these net 0 points, everybody?
We're in quilter session. Time for us between seasons to refine and hone the show, known as Fish Center.
A little bit of that shock jock, edgy radio humor in between. I'm talking about cleavage. You will not believe what we have to say
radio
about that.
Radio cleavage.
Radio cleavage. I'm talking about lower leg. You will not believe what I have to say about that today. But I'm on fire today. I've been busy in my office drawing
That's
lines over
really
Dave's face.
Loud. This is gonna, it's gonna be.
What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Oh, my name's Aubrey. I'm calling from California.
Hey, Aubrey. Welcome to Fish Center. Thank you for calling.
Hey, Fish Center Live. What's your
Thanks
name?
Thanks for answering.
Oh, Cho answered.
Well, after
or Jay answered.
After Jay answered.
Jay answered, then Cho answered.
That's right. Aubrey gets just gotten passed around.
How you doing, Aubrey? What's on your mind?
I heard you guys had some musicians there.
We sure do. Should we introduce them?
You should. I'd really like to see that.
Let's do it. Thanks for calling.
Yeah, thank you guys.
It's a good thing Aubrey's here to help us move along the
I forgot.
Show and not talk about
were we dawdling?
Yeah. That's right.
Below the belt wipes. Oh, these are for your butt.
The
Max. Are you wiping that on
no
your
one
keyboard?
Knows what you're talking about. We're introducing our guests. Talking about your butt. Ladies and gentlemen, a tremendous honor. Can't believe they agreed to do this. But we won't tell them that. The esteemed Bela Fleck, Abigail Washburn. Take it away.
Hey, 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 yo.
We like it serious. I'd like if you guys stop having as much fun. And I'm sorry I said that, but Snakes told me to be meaner.
Wow.
I think she wants to play Coin Quest.
Or she's gassing.
To leave you, how I hate. expect to see you anymore.
Cheer on a friend or lift your own spirits with this motivational sound effect. If you use it in music or a project, let me know what you did and share a link. Enjoy.
You know, after years of using that applaud sound, I went and commented, "We've been using this on Fish Center for years. Waka Flocka was applauded to with this song." Hopefully that makes Paradox Mirror happen.
Yeah. Bela Fleck and Abigail Washburn. That's not that hard what they do.
Matt, I can do that. Come on, don't say stuff like that.
Matt, he made that banjo work for him.
Also, I don't even know when he put that slide on his finger. It was like a magician. I was thinking
the same thing. It's like unfair.
Where'd that slide come from?
They're so nonchalant about creating those sounds.
Yeah.
How?
Cho, you're going too far.
Too far, Cho.
That's too far?
Too far.
Yeah.
My wonderment is out of control.
Cho, you're an amazing pianist.
Yeah.
You don't
have to
be play piano.
Humble.
They're sitting down. They're here with us, joining us now. Getting settled. Getting situated. I think I could do that. I do.
I think, well, you know what I could do easily is Chinese law.
Oh, yeah, anybody can do that.
It's like bada bing, bada boom, you know?
We could team up, Max. You and I could play, I could be a, what is it, the
banjo.
The banjo.
The banjo.
Took a minute.
Named after a man named Joe.
I mean, Matt, you could shred.
Not true. I mean,
I can shred.
I saw you shred yesterday.
Yeah, I can shred, and Max can do Chinese law. Then we can go on tour. They can do
a
fish
the same.
Game show.
Here's the thing. All I gotta say is ni hao and be polite, man. And listen, when you walk through, when you walk through Hong Kong, anyone who speaks English to you and tells you to follow them, you go with them. It's the right thing to do. And they get you really good deals on drinks.
Thank you guys for coming.
But we're busy because we've got some eggs that are about to hatch.
What do you mean?
Oh, mm-hmm.
Oh my God.
Oh, yeah,
Easter.
Oh, you're stealing stuff.
Glad you guys have lots of pillows.
How does that feel? Have you done it before?
Which part?
What's it like?
Oh, it's in a few weeks, I'll have about 14 people looking at my vagina.
Boy.
Should we come back?
And cut.
Is that the third most?
Yeah, well, so it's a real adventure every day because you wake up and something's changed drastically in your body. And the other day I woke up and my legs had grown about 3 inches in width and depth and swollen. And they said go get some compression tights, but make sure you put them on first thing when you wake up in the morning when your legs are the least swollen. And
this is really funny stuff.
it's basically a war zone in there, me in the bedroom and trying to get these compression tights on. But I want to tell you, I have them on. And
you have them on now.
They feel like compression tights, and they help.
They're not Spanx. They're different from Spanx.
And they make
Spanx are not medical level.
They make special ones for carp. You guys may not know that.
What?
They make special ones.
For carp?
Yes. Only freshwater.
Keep them trim and
swim. See, I knew that they could tell that they're fish experts.
Here's a TMI story. I slept with a very pregnant woman last year, and I was very uncomfortable when I felt kicking. And
now we're all uncomfortable.
When we were cuddling, and then there was like a little kick, and I was like, I can't do this.
Come on, really?
That's the miracle of life.
I hate children.
You were so fortunate to experience that.
I looked at her. I said, shut him up. He keeps kicking me. Anyway, that's my story.
All right.
Your new album, Echo in the Valley.
Oh, thanks, everybody.
Congratulations on that. Bela, you have more multi-category Grammy wins than any other artist. We had a guy in here not long ago who was saying the Grammys had bad food.
Yeah, and
is that
rigged.
Accurate?
It's certainly rigged.
What do you mean?
Well, I won a bunch of Grammys, so that's a giveaway.
You didn't deserve those.
You're an insider, is what you're saying.
No, it's a great thing. Thank you very much. I'd like to thank the Academy.
Yeah.
What do you do with them at this point?
Well, we have some in our aquarium, of course.
Really?
Until the fish started to turn green, and then we had to
that was a problem.
Remove them.
Trophies made out of copper.
One of my favorite ways that anybody ever introduced us, this was Bela and I did win a Grammy together. If you make a record with Bela, you probably will win a Grammy.
All right,
that's
let's
just
make
something
one.
I wanted to tell.
Let's do it right
Adult
now.
Adult Swim featuring Bela Fleck. Bela Fleck featuring Fish Center. But before that, we were in Glasgow, Scotland. We were getting ready to play a show in a bar. And the guy came out to introduce us and he said, between them, they have 16 Grammys. Please make them welcome to the stage, Bela Fleck and Abigail Washburn. And it was accurate. It was 16 plus zero. It's good math. It's.
I like that story.
Does your child have a Grammy by default?
Ooh, child Grammy.
Yeah, we put them in the crib with them.
Would you ever, and you'd have to give me 75% of the money you make on it, but make a high concept bluegrass opera album called Child Grandma?
What are you talking about?
Wait.
Would you ever, and you'd have to give me 75% of the profits?
The answer is no.
Okay.
No.
That's a good answer.
That was easy.
I'll have to do it on myself. Anyway, Max is here still.
Anyway, you're here in the middle of quilter session. Do you guys have quilts? Do you use them?
We have quilts.
Tell us about your quilts.
We have quilts with banjos on them.
For
real?
Fans of ours have made delivered to us.
Whoa, we're part of the Appalachian music community, so that means that we come from a tradition of music that is strongly connected to the crafts of Appalachia. So that means that quilts have been a big part of that world of culture. And so as a result, when Juno was born, we got about 5 quilts from people were absolutely, I know, right? They were absolutely gorgeous.
Why are quilts part of that whole deal? I don't understand.
It's handmade.
Crafting.
They need something to put the banjos on top of.
Wrapping a banjo in a quilt. Mm-hmm.
Powerful tradition. Powerful tradition of making beautiful things for your home.
I find quilts depressing.
Yeah, but fried chicken is gone the next day, but a quilt is there forever.
Ooh.
Whoa, deep.
That is profound.
Thank you.
Quilts are forever.
Give us a call, 708-794-6386. You have a question for Bela and Abigail. What's the question that people ask you the most so we can get that out of the way?
Oh.
How many cats are there?
Why the hair?
Why the hair?
Yeah.
What
that's
hair?
That's usually the first question I get, but...
The hair?
No, not really. But what's a good
question?
So
you lied.
Yes. Why do you lie?
Why do you lie
on the air?
Why do you lie?
Why do you insist on lying on the air over and over again?
Guitars out of tumorous, cancerous flesh that's growing hair.
Tell us about the banjo that you have there. It's
tasty. Well, this one I'm playing here is a Gibson Master Tone from 1937.
Oh wow.
It's a hot old banjo. Guy I love a lot named Earl Scruggs started this three-finger rippling style that I do, which is the superior style of banjo, by the way.
What do you mean, three-finger rippling style?
Well, like this sort of thing, you know. Here, I'll put it up by my mic so you can hear it. Was that me? Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know.
Anyway, you ripple, you alternate these three fingers, so you don't have to move any finger very fast, but it sounds really fast because you're playing fast, but it takes very little effort. And Abby plays in a different style, but a lot of times people try to ask us to explain the differences between those styles.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I play clawhammer banjo.
The inferior style.
The actually the superior style.
Wow, it made it awkward.
I don't know. 16 to nothing.
Cressida the car in chat.
What the hell does Bela know?
Cressida the car in chat asks, "What is the future of bluegrass music?"
Whoa, that's a real question.
Beats. You guys see these boot beats and wah pedals?
They're already in there.
Depends who you listen to.
I don't know. It's going pretty good, actually. It's going better than I might have expected about 20 years ago when I was looking at it all go down.
Bela's definitely at the forefront of watching the tradition change in recent times.
Yeah, there's lots of young people playing it and lots of people bringing their own ideas to it, and it's just becoming a more varied art form, which is a beautiful thing.
Earl Scruggs gave you that.
Yeah, he said that.
Do you ever fall asleep with those things on your fingers?
Which things?
The picks.
Finger picks.
I don't see anything.
You get, there's metal finger picks
little
on your fingers.
They gather on your fingers?
Look, like little bishops.
I see them in the camera.
Oh, those.
There's little things on your fingers.
Yes, he's got an adamantium skeleton.
I forget they're there all together sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's a good look.
But they're good for ninja warrior operations because they're sharp.
You should punch all of us repeatedly.
No. Start with Dave.
Please. I was thinking about that, actually.
Yeah.
Can I opt out?
You know, in round two of Coin Quest, we play possibly one of the most modern bluegrass songs of all time.
Yeah. We'll play it for you if you'd like.
That would be wonderful.
All right. We're going to start today with round two. We're
instead of round one, we're doing round two and the start, which is four coins in the inverse Thursday T permission.
With the extra coins, though, are we going to stick
with
that?
There's no extra coins today.
Wait, I thought we were
only in round one. Joe, you're making a mistake.
Bale and Abigail are at the Variety Playhouse tonight. And now when you look out from the stage to the audience, do you imagine coins over different people? And if they dance through them, do you imagine giving them a point?
I like to rate the people in the audience in their worth, their apparent worth from the distance of the stage.
Like their financial worth?
No, just their worthwhealthness as people, that sort of thing.
Who was the hottest person at one of your concerts? And you can say yourself.
Big laugh from the missus.
She likes him for his personality. That's why she's there.
Would it have been Satan, perhaps?
Whoa.
Good answer. Round two.
The hottest person.
You have the right amount of coins out there, Max?
Yep, we've got plus five, a negative five, a negative one, and a plus
one. There's a okay.
As long as it nets zero.
I mean, I just wanted to share that you three gentlemen are there four?
There's four.
Four
of us.
three of us and Tro.
One of them is very insignificant, but the other three, very powerful.
We're not all gentlemen.
Between the four of you, you make three men.
That's
complimentary right there.
Oh boy,
maybe overestimating slightly. Thank you.
There is a really attractive being right here. Actually, I'm really glad you brought him her
studio audience
into our space. Right there, it really makes me feel at home.
Oh, yeah. That guy was waiting for something to happen on the show.
Yeah, it makes me feel things, a lot of things, seeing him there. It could be.
Is that one of the old guests that you just never let leave?
It's actually Mike Lazo. Who
it's Earl Scruggs.
It's Earl Scruggs.
Here we go.
Feel free to play along.
Wait till you hear this song.
There's a new score sheet I'm using thanks to Andy Honius.
Did you print more out?
Yeah.
One for Mimosa. Negative five for Style Toy.
Whoa. I have a company.
Wow. One for Top Xander. Plus five for Ale.
Plus one for Clump. And Clump hits the badass for minus 10.
Aw, Clump.
One for Jeremy Leg.
One for Top Xander.
One more for Clump. One for Slider. One for Jeremy Leg.
One for Ale. One more for Ale. One for Top Xander. One for Ale. Those lower coins not getting a whole lot of action. One more for Ale.
One for Clump.
One for Top Xander.
Not much action on the bottom. That's the end of the round. Oh, that's so good.
Yeah. Thanks for practicing that song for this appearance.
Do you have the secret? Do you have the splits for this?
Yeah, so we can use talking
that
all over.
Oh, damn it.
Yeah. Just gonna have the Coin Quest call out.
It's unbelievable.
Two, Ale got 9 points. That makes Ale our second place fish. Also, at the end of this week with this test, we aren't doing it between two tanks.
What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Becky Barrows, Canton, Georgia.
Becky from Canton. You're on with Bela Fleck and Abigail Washburn. How about that?
That's awesome.
Hi. Hi, Becky.
Hi. I have a question. Is your baby due in June, did I hear?
Yeah, that's right, June 8th.
And do you guys plan to continue to tour after, you know, after some time after the baby's born?
We do, yeah.
Yay. I
mean, not as much as we did, but...
Yeah, after our first boy was born, Juno, we toured. When he was 2.5 months old, we got in a bus and we didn't stop much for a long time. So we're going to take it a little easier this time. I think we'll take like 4 or 5 months off and then... In December, we'll do a tour of the West Coast in a bus, and then with Juno and this little one, and in January,
I don't know how you
February,
do it,
we'll keep
but I'm
going.
I'm glad you do. That's for sure.
Thanks. Do you have any? Do you have any kids?
I have 3 kids and 12 grandkids.
Oh wow. My! Oh,
yeah. Another, you sound like you have a cold.
I do, don't I? I think I've got the allergies.
Oh, that's right. You're in Atlanta, right?
Yeah. That'll in Nashville. Yeah.
And I have a question. Yeah. Bela, I noticed your banjo, the armrest, appears kind of elevated.
You're a banjo picker.
We got a banjo picker.
Yes,
out there.
I'm a wannabe. I've been playing about 2.5 years, and I love clawhammer, but I started learning 3-finger, and I've tried clawhammer. I can't get the hang of it. I don't know. Maybe I just don't try hard enough, but...
You found your home, then, the 3-finger. I'll forgive you.
People usually go one right. way or the other, you know what I mean? It's like
it's hard
a
to
person who gets good at clawhammer usually doesn't get good at 3-finger and vice versa. I don't know why. It's just like a different brain. But good luck.
Yeah, okay,
with
well, I'm going to go with that, then. That makes me feel better.
Me too. I can't do clawhammer.
Now, the art, well, good.
Good.
I'm glad to hear that.
Becky tried to court me by playing clawhammer banjo, Jim Croce tunes, playing clawhammer banjo.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
I wish the world could hear that.
No. Now, I noticed your armrest is raised.
Now, Becky.
Oh, do I need to go?
I have to ask you some questions now.
Uh-oh. Oh, okay.
You've had your fun. Uh-oh. Now it's our turn.
I'm not the celebrity.
Well, in some ways you are. We hear you're kind of notorious. Can you tell us your biggest regret in all of life?
Whoa.
Oh, man.
What is this, dear Maxine?
I certainly wasn't expecting this. My goodness. It's starting to be calling into this show.
Fish said.
Call you tomorrow.
Do you think it's that you didn't stick with clawhammer?
No, I'll tell you. Well, I mean, one of my big regrets is that I didn't stick with the banjo 30 years ago when I first started taking lessons. I did it for a little while, and then I had my children were little, and every time I would practice, they would want to come and play, and, you know, I couldn't concentrate, and then I couldn't do it when they were asleep because it's so darn loud. I'd never heard of a mute. I didn't know they existed, so... Anyway, so I just gave it up for a long time, but yeah, so I just started back a few years ago, but I'm 62 years old now, so I feel like I'm running out of time to get good, you know?
Oh, that's never too late. Yeah, it's just about bringing joy to
about
your life.
About 10 years.
Oh, it does bring joy, yeah. And a certain amount of neck and shoulder pain, but joy for sure.
I know, it's true, isn't it?
Well, that's joy for the chiropractor.
Right? There you go.
And Becky, I did want to say we have a lot of help. That's how we do it. We've got amazing people who help us a lot.
Oh, and Dave.
Thank you.
Oh, wonderful. Well, I've been to 2 of your shows and just was absolutely enthralled. And I would have come tonight, but I don't want to do the standing room only thing. I'm getting too old for that.
Oh,
so.
It's all seated.
What?
No, you don't have an excuse.
No excuses. It's all seated.
No, it's... Are you at Variety Playhouse?
Yeah, it's all seated. Yeah,
they're all seated
nowadays.
They told me it
was standing room only.
Oh, that's a shame.
Maybe they didn't like you.
Oh, maybe they're out.
Of keep you out.
Maybe she means they're out of seated tickets.
I feel like Becky's got a super villain origin story in response to these two. She's just so angry she didn't play 30 years ago, and now she's gonna sabotage them.
She can't play banjo. Nobody can.
Pick my nose now.
I hear a murder ballad coming.
Thank you.
All right.
Thanks for calling.
Good luck with
Bye,
it.
Becky.
You. It's great talking to you guys.
You
Love
too.
You.
Keep playing.
Thanks.
What do you say to bad banjo, like people who don't know how to play banjo who insist on showing
I say,
you.
Honey.
Oh, wow.
Nice.
You guys
throwing shade.
Really rib each
that
other.
That was a good one.
Roasting.
Oh, my God. Hey, those are expensive pillows.
Yeah. Good. Oh, wait, keep that off.
What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Whoa.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey, yeah, my name is Kenny. Hello. And I am from Cincinnati, Ohio.
Hi, Kenny. Hello.
How are you?
Good.
We're good. I was good. Better before.
A couple of questions. Bela, you're playing banjo, and you get an idea, and you want to write a note somewhere. What do you do? Do you have, like, have you maneuvered a pen around your picks, or what
well,
do you do?
Well, there's this incredible invention that's come along recently called the iPhone. And with the iPhone, I can press the instant, what do you call it?
Voice memo.
Voice memo, thank you, my dear.
You're welcome,
I like to take
honey.
Back everything I said before, by the way. Yeah, and I record, countless pointless memos to myself that I never listen to, but they're there. And once in a while, I'm stuck. I'm like, what was that cool thing I thought of the other day? And I can pull it up and listen to it, and then usually I remember it. But aside from that, I write it out in banjo tablature. But it's hard because you got to take your finger picks off to write it down, so it slows down the process.
Do you think you would release an album of just your voice memos? That might be cool.
I thought about it, except they're usually kind of screwed up.
Yeah.
But it would be...
That's works in progress.
I think it'd be for people that I wanted to punish.
Yeah. Well...
Bayless punishments.
That's... Something
the modern day B-sides.
Grammy would frown upon that, I think.
Or it might be revolutionary.
Well, they'd nominate it.
Brave.
You're an insider. You can do anything.
I do have another idea though, which is to do an album. Like I like to play the banjo in the airport when I'm sitting around. I like to record a record in the airport.
Wow. Like at the Cinnabon.
Yeah, exactly. With the announcements and the people walking by saying, hey, I got a banjo.
Or even on an airplane.
On the plane.
Yeah.
Tune it up for the whole
flight.
I see
people making beats on airplanes sometimes. So,
do you, Dave? Really?
Yeah. Well,
How many people have you seen
make? Well, listen, I have an OP1.
Dave Bonowitz.
So yourself has done that.
Well, and I've seen other people, too. That's why I did it. I'm in this since...
Kenny,
like
are you watching the screen?
I am watching the screen.
Would you like to play a game for points for fish, or do you want to go on a demolition derby turn around?
I forgot
in
Kenny
real
was
life.
Here.
I'm here. I am here.
Oh,
glad you're here.
We're glad you're here still.
We're playing a very famous game called Wash or Burn, in which you look at a washing machine hole and you tell me, is that a burn on singed flesh, or is it dirty laundry? It's a very good game for 15 points called Wash or Burn. Kenny, do you get the concept, and are you screaming in joy? Full.
Woo!
Woo!
This is why our son cannot watch this show.
He has no eyes.
Because he has no eyes. Kenny, you gotta give me an answer. Look at that and talk me through your process.
Okay. So what am I supposed to do? I see wash or burn.
Is this something in the that you should put in the wash, or did somebody burn their flesh?
Oh.
You know, like when you fall hand first into an extinguished fire pit and then you spend the rest of your camping trip with your hand in a glass of water?
And naked and afraid this season.
Oh, it happened to me.
Yeah,
lady's hot water fell on her.
All right, Kenny, take a look.
Okay.
Walk us through your thinking.
Yeah. So I have to guess what's
she
in there, correct?
Too.
Well, you got two options,
actually,
Kenny.
Is it
and
burned
I'll explain
skin
this
or the dirty laundry?
Very quickly to you. It's either singed flesh or dirty laundry.
Hmm. Wash or burn, and I'm trying to think. I think of like I'm trying to get the game.
10 seconds.
I'm trying to get this game. So that thing is in the dryer. So like, I have to guess this.
We might have to.
What is going on?
It's a guess.
Two of this show.
Is this a dirty
five
clothing
something
or sheet or something? Or is it a burn?
Wow. Don't hang up, Cho. He's got it.
That is a burn.
That's a burn. Okay,
you're saying
Kenny.
It's a burn for the 50 points. Let's see. Washer burn. It was a stained shirt.
Oh. Wow.
Well, it looks like a burn shirt.
Hold on. It's a,
that's
burn,
a burn shirt.
Shirt.
Max. Oh, my God. It's a burn.
Kenny's 50
points. There you go, Kenny. Yeah. Technically, either.
It took a while for me to figure out the game. I am really sorry. I'm a
little
slow.
It's okay. You got that Ohio brain level.
Yes.
Who's getting the points?
Can I do another?
No,
you got Kenny. You're so excited.
Kenny, it's now he's Friday. Hooked.
You're going to look at dirty laundry all
you
day.
Want to go to Vegas with us, Kenny?
He's the next CW.
Yes.
Extreme.
That answer came quick.
If you had to give 15 points to any of the fish you've seen swimming around today, which one would you give based on instinct?
There was a blue one, right?
There was.
Mimosa is
probably
pretty blue.
Mimosa or Top Xander. Pink tail or yellow face?
Let's go with the yellow face blue one.
That's Mimosa.
Yellow face blue one for 15 points. That throws Mimosa up into fourth place at 22 points. What a fabulous week of net zero attempts.
Thanks, Kenny.
Have you here.
Hey, not a problem.
I feel like he's being patronizing to us.
No, he's just a genuine dude.
Yeah, I don't know.
Trust issues with people who are nice, Max?
Is it time to say goodbye to Kenny, or is he still?
He's gone.
Oh, bye, Kenny.
So long, Kenny.
He exploded.
Thanks, what's your name, Kenny? Where you're calling from?
Hey, it's Roland. I'm calling from Cleveland, Ohio.
Is this Kenny again?
Oh, my God.
It's Kenny.
No, that's the other end of the state. That's the hillbilly section.
So you're
this
part
is
of the
northeast
elite.
Corner near,
all right, Roland.
It's close to Canada.
Very smart.
Which is why I'm here.
That's very foreign. Smart.
Nice, very nice.
Cleveland, of course, is the Hamilton of the United States.
Roland.
Yep.
Hamilton. College town, right?
Calzin.
Here comes Roland's question.
Okay, the question is, Bela.
Uh-oh.
Do you now or have you ever practiced with a metronome? How much do you practice with a metronome?
Let me answer that for you.
That's my first question.
Roland, this man is a, what would I say? He's very committed to the metronome. I think it competes with me for private.
I was going to say, that
life.
It sounds risky.
Whoa. Roland.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Make the metronome your friend. That's my suggestion.
Make it a threesome. Make it waltz time.
Easy, Roland.
Back off, dude.
A second question I do have, if I may, is...
I think I hear one.
Has anyone ever mistaken you for Seamus Egan?
Oh, let me answer that one, Roland.
They sometimes mistake him for me.
Both play banjo, so...
Yeah, the white part is exactly the same.
Thanks, Roland.
Yep. I think Seamus and Bela might have a little man crush on each other.
He's a good man. He's a good fellow. Good musician, good dude.
Here we go. This is exciting.
Oh, wow, you're fast.
And that was slower than it could have been.
But he wins the George Clooney Award, which I don't get.
I like
he's a handsome guy. That's a vest he's wearing. Do you ever wear a vest when you play?
I never. Absolutely never. And look at that blingy banjo. Look at that blingy banjo.
He's cool.
I like the loose tie, too.
Mm-hmm. He just got off work.
What does that
now
say
he's
about
relaxing with the banjo.
Three
what
bracelets? He's like an Egyptian.
He holds it like a baby.
What's that?
He looks like he just got off work at Applebee's.
Seamus.
Seamus.
We're so sorry to do this to you.
How did this happen to Seamus?
What is this, a big zit? Oh, my God. Disgusting.
Seamus, wash your face.
Shameful.
He's the teenager of banjo playing.
Max, I know you have a game for these guys before they go back. And
Just so you all know, he's one of the finest Irish musicians.
Oh, that's not what you said before.
Irish music. Yeah, but when the cameras are off. That faker is so bad at Irish music. Playing a game called Chow Bella Flex. And it's for you two to play. This is one of the best ideas I've had in minutes.
Finally.
Let me full screen it.
You guys have to look at this, and you can compete to decide what muscle is behind this part of the Italian flag.
It'll come up full screen for you.
That's right. What muscle is behind the Italian flag ripped open on Chow Bella Flex, the game on
the
Fish Center Live?
Oh, the flex is like tendons or something. I get it now.
So wait.
They have to guess
what
which
muscle is behind the ripped hole of the Italian flag, Cho. What don't you understand?
It's the it's the Prometheus.
Prometheus?
Yes.
Okay.
Is that a muscle? I didn't know that.
It is now.
Mm. I think that's a dude.
Abigail, would you like to steal?
I'm going to go with trapezoid.
Trapezoid or Prometheus?
Trapezoid or Prometheus? For the 25 points, I will now remove the flag. It was the bicep.
Oh, that's so easy. That's so boring.
It was an easy
was
one
so
to start
boring.
With. It's not boring. It's
boring.
The bicep's very important. You use it to...
Everybody says bicep.
Well, so you just wanted to be different instead of win? Here, you want to try and try it again? You want to try again?
Try again?
Yeah.
Here we go. With your knowledge now of the game, that was a mulligan.
This one is not any easier.
Sure it is.
Oh, well, if you're a doctor, maybe.
I know it.
Bullshit.
I used to look at anatomy books all the time.
What is it?
You know, I had
kind of a weirdo, weren't you, Dave?
I knew this mother of a few women when I was, a few young women when I was young, and she was doing massage, and she said one of her daughters would steal the massage book to go masturbate.
Why are you a womanizer?
Isn't that funny?
You gotta improve your stories.
The massage book.
Well, I know what it is.
When you're like 12, that must be fun.
It's the Stradivarius humungulum.
Stradivarius humungulum. Abigail for the steal.
Can I throw it on my call card? Can I call my friend?
Yes.
Yeah, call your friend.
Oh, I don't have my phone.
Okay.
Just yell out really loud.
Michael Weintraub, if you're watching this, I just feel like you'll know the answer to this.
Michael Weintraub.
I wonder if Michael Weintraub's in the chat.
708-794-6386. Michael.
Jay, if anyone calls and says they're Michael Weintraub, even if it's clearly not them, let
put
them
through.
Yes. Don't you think he'd know?
He'd definitely know.
He would definitely
he might even
know.
Have one.
Why would Michael Weintraub
think
know?
Michael Weintraub watches Fish Center?
He knows everything.
He probably does, and he just does know everything. Yeah, he's an EMT, and he's also does all, like, amazing things with computers and stuff.
I got to meet this Michael Weintraub.
Yeah, you do. You actually do.
Oh, here
Renaissance
he is.
Man.
If you're lucky.
Okay.
Michael Weintraub.
There he is.
That's not him.
That's Michael Weintraub.
You guys have yeah. young
he has
friends.
A hoodie.
That is not Michael
that
Weintraub.
That is Michael Weintraub.
Any friends that young. No way.
No way. That is not him.
There's you back there in this window. Hello.
Okay.
He's got a nice website. Do you think he made it's that it. With Squarespace?
Or maybe Wix.
Wix.
All right. He's not calling.
All right, Abby, you're going to have to do yeah. this on your own.
It's not going to happen.
You
okay.
know, I once dated an Abigail, and my nickname for her was Abs.
Yep, that happens.
Oh, is that a, was that a hint?
No.
Oh,
not at all.
Oh,
that
cheating.
Was a
hint.
Stuff that
stuff
away.
That was
cheating.
A hint.
Or subterfuge.
No, I think it's... I don't know what it is, honestly, but I don't think it's Abs.
I think you're giving a hint, because I know all your ex-girlfriends. I don't remember an Abigail.
Wishful thinking. Selective made-up memory.
Amnesia.
I also dated a bicep petunia.
Oh my
thank
gosh.
You. I'm going to be here for another 10 minutes.
Awful. Not
terrible.
Likely hate this job sometimes.
Okay.
hate this job.
How do you think we feel?
I know. Right?
They have to play
at
banjo.
Least you guys can leave.
your publicist is on the phone.
Oh, yeah?
Is she really?
No.
Oh, she probably know.
Because her husband is Michael.
Yeah, our publicist's husband actually is Michael
okay.
Weintraub.
Wow,
yeah.
Well, that could have been.
That was oh, my God. The right, Weintraub joke.
All right, Abigail. Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go with Psoas.
All right. Next.
Psoas?
Reveal the muscle.
Psoas?
I guess.
This was the trapezius.
Oh, that's what I meant when I said trapezius.
Would trapezoid would have been, that been acceptable?
Well, for partial credit, probably.
Would it mean that we wouldn't have to play another song?
What's your name? Where are you calling from?
My name's Jessica, and I'm calling from Nashville.
Ah, Jessica!
I was calling for the ab thing because Carla told me to tell you it was an ab.
She
it's
did.
Not an ab.
Mm-hmm.
Tell Carla. Would have been wrong. Really wrong.
I'm putting 25 points in the bucket.
Michael would have known the answer,
it?
Wouldn't he have?
Oh.
He would have known. It's a
trapezius.
Which
I can see it now. Yeah.
I guessed it on the last one, and it was, but I called it a trapezoid.
Which is a band.
Shape.
It's a band.
Oh, it's a band.
They're kind of square, but not exactly.
What are you doing right now?
Well, I'm just
you're on the phone.
Blowing up the group text, watching you guys on television or on the computer.
Is it fun?
It's really fun. We're doing a lot of screenshots of the comments on the right.
Oh, yeah, the chat. Who gives a shit about the chat?
I'm like, I don't even know who these people are. It's amazing.
They're like shoe fresh.
That's why they don't matter.
Boy, hockey boy. Forenzy.
It's distracting, though. I like that someone thought the last one was bacon.
Did anybody in your group chat put in quotes bicep petunia and then other people held it and pressed ha-ha? In the chat?
No.
We also have another chat, talk.io, talk.io/fishcenter. It's a ragtag bunch
of misfits.
That's
like a sleazy chat, though.
They post
I can't join the chat because I don't have a login, and that seems like work.
Put your hands together, and we'll get these guys to play another number for us.
Are they together?
Are who together?
Your hands.
The people on my hands? Are totally.
Yeah, put them together.
Yeah.
Can you make like a little like this noise with your hands so we know they're together?
I don't know if that microphone's the right.
I'm not really good with that noise,
that
but I can imagine what you're doing, but I don't know how to do that.
No, wait, like the hand fart?
Aren't you guys supposed to be fish?
No, we're dudes.
Okay. They're fish. Definitely dudes, Jessica.
Fish or,
we're homo sapiens sapiens, man.
We're three dudes.
Maybe three and a half. She said maybe three and a half.
I didn't
That was the best one, Abby.
Oh, Daedalus in chat says, hi, Jessica.
Thanks, Jess. Appreciate that.
We love you.
Thanks, Jess.
Love you guys.
Talk to you later.
Have a good rest of your show. Bye.
Bye.
They're here promoting their album Echo in the Valley.
Now nobody's going to buy.
Well, come on.
It's very bad.
What's the best way to buy it?
You guys have a very unflattering angle on our position on the couch.
Spotify, Apple Music, Amazon Music.
We can switch to
digital download, CD, vinyl. Their previous self-titled album, Together, won a Grammy for Best Folk Album. Tonight at the Variety Playhouse.
There are seats.
Tomorrow, and there are seats available. Tomorrow, you can lie down. Tomorrow in Birmingham. How about the tour dates? Why don't you put them up while these guys go get ready?
Oh.
All right. We're doing one more.
Bye, guys.
Thanks, guys.
We're going to miss you a lot.
We'll miss you. We'll see you in a minute, though.
See you next year.
I can't wait to get out of here.
Oh, my God, Joe eagerly sandbags so much.
It's not sandbagging. It's just observation.
They're giggling and having a good time, and you say they can't wait.
Look how beautiful.
Leave.
He's helping her up. So nice.
No, Dave,
you got the tour dates?
Man, what a great show. Oh, look how pink that tail has become. Beautiful.
It's today. Go back, would you? Oh, look at this. Atlanta, Birmingham, Savannah, Denver, Wilkesboro, Rochester, Toronto, Ottawa, Lenox, Mass.
That's at Lenox Mall.
Porchester, the greatest theater in America.
Oh, the capital?
Yeah.
Brevard.
Back.
Montreal, Portland.
They have a Brevard residency.
Brevard.
It's like an entire week.
Brevard.
That's a residency.
Yeah, look at that.
Oh, aren't we doing one of those?
Why are some... Oh, some are... And they're color-coded. The orange ones, Bela Fleck and Abigail Washburn. Red ones, Bela Fleck with orchestra.
All right.
What about the gray ones, Dave?
Bela Fleck and the Flecktones.
This doesn't make sense.
I love color-coding.
They've come all the way from this room down the hall to Studio C, William Street Memorial Veterans... Memorial Soldiers and Sailors Coliseum. Our new friends, Bela Fleck, Abigail Washburn. Thank you for being here, guys.
Such a long way. There's an echo.
understanding you love.
Fleck, Abigail Washburn, thanks for coming on, guys.
Bye, guys. Great.
See him tonight at the Variety here in Atlanta. Tomorrow in Birmingham. Buy their new album, Echo in the Valley. Probably win a Grammy, I guess. Coming up on the streams. Watch the first episode of On Cinema, season 10, because you're about to get a new one at 7 o'clock. Development meetings live tonight. Coming at you from Burbank. Pitch your show ideas to Adult Swim. Maybe they'll buy it from you and make it. Potato Chat's live after that. No one says potato. Some people say tomato. But it's a tomato and a potato and they talk to each other. Is that right? Is that what happens?
No.
Blood Feast after that.
Stay tuned for Twin.
What happens in that?
Twin.
Doesn't matter.
Twins.
Twins.
Watch and see what happens.
Twins. We have twins tonight.
Just one guy, though.
We only got one of the twins, but we're going to explore what it means to be a twin brother.
Okay. Thank you for joining us. Thank you to our special guests, Bela Fleck, Abigail Washburn. Thank you for joining us for Quilter Session. We'll be back tomorrow. Got another special guest tomorrow. Stand by for a colorful graphic. Thank you.
Here comes Jim with the gray in his boots that jingle. He smiles wide and throws his eyes. Lies that tangle. Have you ever been outside of Baltimore County line? Could you tell me about the sky at night, untouched by downtown's light? And every time just pray for rain, knowing one day the gonna clap, that heaven's gonna have your name. Sing me songs of California. Take me dancing, pretty mama. You know I said out to warn you. This place is haunted. Now do you wanna you come soft, walking tall with this popular gait? He wonders how, then takes his bow, an outside midnight way. Have you ever been outside, headed either north or south? Could you tell me about the other side of where the mouth lets out? Time you feel the earth shake, or you just do the same. Knowing one day the ground will open up, that devil's gonna have your name. Put me on a train to New York. The water. And all I ever wanted was to die with pride. A soul full of hate, grace and sorrow. Just